is controlled by Purdue. And one of the big boosts for them, Lance Jones. He picked it out of the air. Braden Smith can help run the point. He and Fletcher Lawyer in the backcourt. And Smith, this is the shot he loves. And he gets off to a good start.
Yeah, and he's very patient, as you saw just then in that first move towards the basket. He understands where there is a driving opportunity. Matt Painter said his decisions have been very good. And that pull-up jumper has a slight bend to it, falling away, but he's comfortable.
There's the hedge defensively up top, and Thornton is caught in a tie-up, and the possession remains with Ohio State.
Absolutely, and also if he's going towards his right top, he's very efficient at getting to the basket.
Shot clock is under 10. Ohio State in a little bit of trouble right out of the gate. Rodney Gale on the baseline, off the side of the backboard, no good.
Big decision by Matt Painter just then to come out and double-team Thornton twice.
Here's Jones. His three is good.
I had a chance to speak with Matt Painter, and he has put the tag on this guy that he could be the wild card for his team. They're, I think, early on in this game, obviously under control, but they're a better team this year than they have been in the last 2 years.
Yeah, he spent 4 years at Southern Illinois, and this is his fifth season of college basketball. He's averaging over 16 in the last four games. Gale off the screen, into the paint, has it knocked away by Edie, and Lawyer has it. There's Smith leading the break with Jones, and Jones for three again. No good. Gale with an easy rebound. I think Gale needs to play well today, so does Thornton.
Yeah, they do, and I think that what they have to do is you see where Edie is, he's just walked back, way back here, so what they got to do is they got to pull up top from about 7 to 10 feet away. Don't challenge him when he's looking right at you.
Backing his way in is Akpar. Shot clock is under 10. There's the double team. Doesn't get the roll, but Ohio State gets the offensive board and the steal by Smith.
Beautiful tip just then, too. You get it to Lawyer.
Fletcher Lawyer averages just under 11 a game, but he hasn't been the offensive player they need over the last couple games.
Yeah, only one field goal made in the last two games, one each per game. Not his style.
Here's Smith off the screen. He thought about it. There's the pass down low, and a foul. Count the bucket. Well, sends Kaufman Wren to the free throw line. Not a great free throw shooter, 52% of the year, but he converts the three-point play. And the fans are still on their feet in the student section because Ohio State has not scored yet.
We're hoping that they sit down in a relatively soon period of time.
First substitution, Dale Bonner in the game for the first time. Thornton pull up Jay. He's fouled. Jones called for the foul, and Bruce Thornton with the bucket. And he finishes off the three-point play. And they talked to him this week about the change in coaches, and he said that he needs to be, even though he's only a sophomore, available mentally for his teammates while they go through something that not many team players go through.
No, this is a very unique situation. And that's why, you know, you just try to tweak a couple of things. They want to play a little bit more up-tempo.
Lawyer down low, gets it to Kaufman Wren, backing his way in, off the glass, got the angle.
Yeah, not badly defended either just then. Mahaffey guessing right on that jump hook to the right side. Notice how they're playing this right now with Edie on Mahaffey.
Mm-hmm. Thornton for three, up top, it's good in rhythm.
The other thing he does well, too, Tom, I just highlighted the fact that he can shoot that mid-range. He's got a real good body in terms of 6'2", 215, but very good shooter from the three-point range. Sometimes he takes them a little quick, maybe, but he's aggressive.
Yeah, he takes or gathers 21% of the points for Ohio State. Smith to Lawyer, a little shot fake, and a foul up top. His brother was a star here at Ohio State. And is now coaching with Thad Mata at Butler.
Too easy a catch down there.
Well, he's busy today, isn't he?
Well, if they're sliding the second guy into the traffic, and by that I mean with Edie trying to get some people to slide in front of him to keep his footwork off cue, then he's going to have a big day on the post off Kaufman Wren.
He had 9 points against Minnesota. He has 7 already in this first half.
Watch behind you.
There's the pass. Edie off his feet. Has it blocked away.
Boy, that's some athletic ability just then.
Here's Jones to the basket, blocked from behind.
Here's where they want to push a little bit, too, Tom. Get it up and down, a little intensity.
Yeah, they worked on a two-man game in practice, too, when they did that. But Thornton takes the shot, gets his old rebound. Oh, he's wide open on the baseline.
Well, notice on the right side, too, though, he recognized there was somebody lurking like at around 7 feet four, 300
somebody
pounds.
Somebody was lurking.
And then he slid to the other side for that little foot shot.
It's funny you say that. Everybody around the country knows who you're talking about. Thornton has all the points so far. And 80 with the catch and the finish. Thornton's looking for his first point since the end of January. Neuer along the baseline gets it to go. He had a great year last year.
He did. And they need a little more action from him, consistency. Sometimes he goes through those little mini slumps as a player throughout the course of the year, but you just got to continue with this team. Just continue to roll, play your role as best you can.
Here's Thornton from the corner, fader no good, and Morton runs down the rebound. Smith, extra pass to Neuer. I will say, watching Braden Smith on film, his lawyer from the free throw line doesn't get it to go, and the rebound by Ohio State, and it's knocked out of bounds by Morton. 6-point lead for Matt Painter's team. Dale Bonner brings the ball off the floor. Zed Key in the first time for Ohio State. His role has changed this year for the Buckeyes. And the freshman Devin Royal is in. He's along the baseline.
See the way that Purdue is cheating into the middle of the floor to help Edie out. Look at them all. They're all just bunched around in there. Somebody's got to hit a 15-footer.
Shot clock is at 5. Key off the side of the iron, and E with the rebound.
Probably because what happens when you're doing that, you continually look for not only Edie, but now you're looking for multiple Purdue players in the lane, and it's just, you know, it distracts yourself, and you start thinking about things other than just making a shot.
Smith up top to Lawyer, inside for Edie. He did get a stab by Key, and he steals it away. And Edie, by the way, picked up that first rebound. He is now 5 away from becoming the all-time leading rebounder in Purdue history. Shot clock is at 7. I don't think Smith realizes it. Now he does. Edie does with 2 on the shot clock.
I think that was Key down below, wasn't it?
It was.
You're not going to block it high, but you can block it low on him.
Is it Key? Last year, he averaged 11 points per game. He's down to 7.2 this season. But as one of the leaders on this team, he'll take that 3. And it's good. That's huge.
Yeah, and you recall when we were speaking to Matt Painter before, was a center on the other team of 4 or 5 going to shoot the ball from there? And he said, well, we got to respect it. If he can hit a couple of those, the dynamics change a little bit in terms of who's going to go out and guard him.
Dropped about 20 pounds from last year. Lawyer to the basket, high off the glass, no good. Wow. Puts it back. That's his second rebound. He gets his bucket.
Yeah, the hands. Very, very good hands.
Thornton, little shot fake. Up top, Royal for 3. No good.
Nothing on the offensive glass for Ohio State. Gale, the only one trying to get around the baseline.
And that's going to be a foul called on Zach Edie.
I don't know full court pickup, Tom, but I might be up there picking him up at half court.
Yeah, just to kind of tackle him a little bit.
Yeah.
And first call for the foul.
Yep. Good post up by Royal.
He only had 2 free throw attempts in the Wisconsin loss the other day.
The power forward or the center. Without Edie in there, you're thinking, let's drive this right to the bucket.
Yeah, challenge first a little bit.
Yep.
A little pressure.
Force Matt Painter to put him back into the game.
Practice the other day, they were doing this pressure, then they fall back into the man-to-man defense, and they were trying to get aggressive with it.
Yeah, it's just a little bit to take some time off the clock, make you think about what's set defensively they're in. And these guards are pretty good at recognizing things.
Jones, shot fake into the paint, runner is no good, and the ball tipped out. Jones gets it back.
Nice hands. Bonner.
When he plays a lot, they win.
Yeah, exactly.
It's weird. There's Key down low. There's the double team.
Look underneath. Nope, he missed it. Royal was wide open for a second.
Royal's 21. Does he need to be a little more vocal on that?
Probably yell a little scream. I would.
Yeah. Hey, I'm open. Middleton cutting to the basket. Paul James blocks. And that foul is going to go on Royal. And Purdue with the basketball at a 4-point lead. Edie is on the bench, so first continues on as the 5-man. Hoffman, Wren, low post, they get it to first.
Yep, looking for him on the blocks, now he sprays out. And he'll work his way back to the block.
Shot clock is at 5, foul on the floor. That foul's gonna go against Zed Key.
Oh, nice cut.
Wow, just can't finish around the bucket the first time or the second time.
That was a beautiful cut, the first one. I can't believe he missed both of those, though. Upstairs, good catch.
Yeah, Key trying to get his bearings. There's four guys around him, and he lays it in.
I love the way Tommy, he didn't catch it initially, right? The ball goes down around his ankles, and what does he do? He scoops and charges to the basket at the same motion to finish it off that much faster.
I thought it was interesting at practice the other day. At the end of practice, he spent a lot of time with Jake Diebler after practice, Ed Key did. You know, kind of patting him on the back after everything that was going on. Braden Smith, shot fake. Now he's open from 17. Doesn't get the roll, and the ball knocked away by Key.
Not a bad ball fake, though.
Ball fake is a lost art in college basketball. Gale cutting to the basket.
Here's the double team.
And he's on his game.
That's the way to play basketball. That's the way to react, make things happen.
And all of a sudden, tied up at 16.
And they want to get the ball down the court a little quicker so they don't have to play against the half-court sets for Purdue defensively. That's kind of like a highlight film of how they want to play half-court offense.
Well, they fell behind 8-0. They're on a 16-8 run. Three-pointer from Jones. No good. Rebound is tipped around and out of bounds. That's consuming the entire middle for Purdue. Checks back in after a cut to the basket.
Maybe clog that up a little bit.
Apara back in also for Ohio State. Thornton.
Needy outside too. Maybe a lob opportunity if he continues to come out. Apara.
Thornton from the baseline. In and out. And the ball knocked along the baseline to Jones. That's a good save by Jones.
Yeah, it's just not fair this game sometimes. Thornton's shot was a beauty. I didn't know how that missed.
Edie looking for it, trying to post up against Alcara. Jones, 1-for-7 so far from the floor.
That's a good post up.
Very quick pass, two-handed jump. That's knowing your teammate.
Yeah, it's knowing your teammate and also working the guy offensively up the lane just a little bit. You got to push him towards the free throw line. He doesn't need a whole lot of room to catch the ball, but he's so strong down below, too. You know, he doesn't look like he's listed at 300 pounds, but fairly well distributed. Mm-hmm.
Four assists, by the way, already for Smith. Gale, shot no good. Ball tipped around. And here comes Braden Smith. And that layup is good. Heidi's able to lay that one in. That's five assists now for Braden Smith.
And the one thing about that pass, made that play look very easy on the break. But I got to tell you how difficult, Tom, that pass is to touch it over a defender and lay it out there for your teammate.
It almost sounded like Matt Painter and the coaching staff had long talks with Smith on two levels. Zampara can't convert the jam.
Yeah, there was that lob opportunity. Just talking about that a second ago. If Edie releases and comes out 12 feet, you'll get a lob opportunity.
Smith off the high screen. Pull-up Jay. He's very good at that. 44% on those pull-up jumpers.
And the other part of it, too, Tommy, has like a drift going left, and he drifts going right also. So, but it's okay if you do that. If you do that normally and you adjust your shot, he does it beautifully.
Somehow not on the Kuzi list for the best guards in the country, the final list, but is on the Naismith list for player of the year.
Second leading rebounder on this team, too.
There's a three up top. It's good.
Need some contribution from other guys. Continue to play hard with enthusiasm, make things happen. But you've got to make some shots at the same time.
Scotty Middleton was the first five-star recruit for Chris Holtman. There's a foul from behind.
They don't have to come off the floor that often.
Right. You always have a coach on the floor. There's Jones with that first cut.
Lewis gets it to Lawyer. They go inside for Edie, who's fouled. They're going to get Jamison Battle on that hold.
Like 213th in the NCAAs with their free throw shooting.
Yeah, 71%.
Yeah.
He's been, as a team, they've been 60% the last four. Mom Jules get a chance to soak in a game with her son as one of the 7 or 8,000 visitors here today for Purdue.
Too.
Yeah. Members against Purdue the last three games, including a huge Big Ten tournament game against Ohio State, 24-19, five-point lead for the Boilermakers.
Now, since the start of last year, Edie has averaged 23 points and 13 rebounds a game from the beginning of last year.
I think as we've watched, he understands his abilities and what he can do more as Battle steps out of bounds.
I played against him for a night or two in the NBA.
Was it that magical when you saw him?
I shut him down.
Yeah, you did. AIAW ran women's athletics before the NCAA recognized women's sports. That's why you saw Lynette Woodard and what her moniker was underneath.
And Clark has just been spectacular for basketball this year, hasn't she?
Absolutely. Spectacular for basketball, spectacular for women's basketball. Here's Lawyer cutting to the hoop.
Probably a block shot also.
Lawyer converts the free throw.
It's shooting 5-for-18 from the floor. Just not him.
Yeah, last year he had 384 points as a freshman, which was the fourth most by a Purdue freshman in school history. But as you said, sometimes shooters get into slumps. There's Thornton speeding along the baseline.
See, Edie, how quick he is to get back. Underrated in terms of athletic ability.
Here's Thornton, step back three, no good. And Key tried to get the rebound. Battle for the loose ball. It'll be E that comes out of the pile with it.
It's Smith looking over everybody.
Lawyer along the baseline. Contact. Nothing was there. Edie with the offensive board. Gillis with a shot fake and a leaner. And we'll keep tabs on Edie and how many rebounds he got on that exchange. He's up to five, so he's now tied Joe Barry Carroll for the most rebounds in school history. One away from setting the new record.
Somebody's got a fill, help him out on the left side.
Ooh, he was able to get some space.
Or just turned and put it in.
I think he was surprised.
And I think Edie thought that he was not going to be able to turn that way and get a shot off.
So a five-point lead for Purdue. Heading toward the five-minute mark here in the first half.
Here we go.
And Edie holds it out of the way. He's done a good job with that this first half.
A little fear of the cheerleaders
below. They go back to Edie, low post.
It's a double team. Let's see who goes to get him.
Two on the shot clock. Can't finish it. And Thornton with the rebound. Right. He got bodies.
Yeah, but that jump hook was about 8 feet away rather than 6 or 4 feet away.
Which the percentage goes down so much on that.
Thornton's a good defender here, too.
In for the first time. Whistle blows. Underneath.
Due to time constraints, we now move ahead in the action.
The crowd involved. Yeah, and Jake Diebler told us when he took over for Chris Holtman after Wednesday's firing, he said, I want them to be more aggressive going to the cup. And that's exactly what they did there.
Because generally, in watching them on film, they do a lot of curl cuts around the baseline. They haven't done any of that in this first half.
There's a traveling ball. Yeah. 31-30, 10-2 run for the Buckeyes. Under two to play here in the first half. Thornton, 18-footer.
I don't know how the next minute 45 is going to play out, but this has played out pretty nicely for Ohio State after what's occurred this week.
Yep.
They have really reacted.
And a timeout called by Purdue.
And I can guarantee you that locker room meshes to these guys if they play in the last minute or so here. Confidently will be a good one.
And here's Kaufman Wren. Shot is no good. Gets his own rebound twice. And a jump ball is called. Middleton got involved. It'll remain Purdue basketball with 20 on the shot clock. So many turns. Because it doesn't happen that often in college hoops where you have a change like this. Smith with 15 on the shot clock. Now to Lawyer. Lawyer pull-up jumper is no good.
It's a good no call, too. He tried to bait the officials into a call just then. Nice look.
Zed Key didn't realize he was that wide open.
Yeah, turn and do something with it. There you go.
Heading toward the one-minute mark. Can't get it to go. Royal, the freshman, though. Put back is good.
How about Royal? Out of position when he got that rebound. But I love the way he just turned and then said to himself, I got to square my shoulders to the basket or I'm not going to get a good look. And he did just that to finish it off.
Purdue has only trailed at the half five times this year. Here's Lawyer, his runner, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Gale.
Boy, the white shirts are just really, really helping one another
Thornton, short, heat check. And Gale is fouled on the floor by Gillis.
To block out all the distractions that are around with that and just try to, as difficult it is, Tom, to get them to think basketball.
Yeah, he said that his priority is not about himself. It's about Ohio State and the Ohio State family. Here's Royal for three, no good. Rebound tipped around. Royal has it and then loses it to Zed King.
They could sit on this just about if they want.
Yep, 2 second difference, shot clock, game clock, which is going to liven up this crowd.
And Adebo came all the way down, almost a half court, to make sure Thornton was aware of that, which I think he was anyway.
Yeah, he just disregards the screen. Zed Key to the corner, Middleton, the freshman with two on the shot clock, no good, and that'll do it. It wouldn't have counted, but it would have been impressive.
Are both 1 for 7 in that first half.
Yep.
One of those two guys has to get on track. I'm thinking it's going to be Jones.
Well, here's Thornton, who had a very good first half for the Buckeyes. And along the baseline, too strong. Ball tipped around. He'll get it back, though.
Heafy with his hand on the ball. He can roam around a little bit more so because Edie's been guarding him.
Think about that. Mahaffey and Battle really didn't do much offensively in the first half for the Buckeyes. Gale with the shot clock at 5, working against Edie off the backboard, no good. And Edie with the rebound, and that gives him the all-time record in Purdue basketball history, 1,149, passing Joe Barry Carroll. It's not going to be the last record that he breaks for Purdue either.
Not going to be the last rebound he gets either.
Inside off the glass, and you can see how deep he gets.
Yes, then it's over if he can really get down low, as his mom likes that move. And the
sure
score.
Does.
There's trouble, right? He backs into him. He has to make a decision to get out of there with Edie.
Okpara along the baseline. And there's the double team. He tries to sweep himself out of it with Battle.
Yeah, Battle's been quiet, too.
Yeah, they'd love to get him free with some threes. That pass to Mahaffey, and he's able to go for the baseline. Not an easy shot.
The interesting part, too, about that possession to me, Tom, is that they didn't have it going real smoothly, but they used the clock, and they weren't afraid to use that clock under 5 seconds to make an extra pass to keep the ball moving, and they get something out of it.
Yeah, they improvised at the ends. Lawyer to Smith. Smith looking in. Not much is there for Kaufman Wren. They go to Edie. Might as well. Oh, he sweeps it down along the baseline. Good look.
See the release defensively. The double team, when he comes across the middle of the floor, they have to run somebody at him. You got to get there a little quicker, maybe to get that ball off the dribble.
That's 9 points for Kaufman Wren. He averages 6.6 per game. Gale snaking. Okpara, and he's fouled underneath.
That's a second team foul on Purdue.
Battle on the curl. He's got it on the free throw line. His first shot attempt of the day. It's good.
Tom, they don't look like a team that's been disrupted.
No.
They look very connected, if you will, to each other on the floor and also to the bench and the coach.
Well, that's exactly what Jake Diebler said this week at practice. He said, I met with each of the players individually. He said, I called their parents individually. Okpara, by the way, will check out. He has 3 fouls for Ohio State.
Post up action, but he's too far out on the floor.
Yeah, Lawyer cut off, and there's a traffic jam. Shot clock under 10. Smith looking to get it to Edie. Well, he dribbled into traffic, but a step back three. No good. Battle with the rebound.
Yeah, real good job, though, by Gale getting there. Watch out. Yeah. Those are the ones you can't turn back. You're up 5 points against Purdue.
39-34, the number two team in the country against Ohio State. They go to Edie. Edie, hook shot. That's what you talked about before. A little closer inside the logo.
And he's very patient to get there.
No, he has 10. Double-figure scoring is not a big deal for him.
Battle with his foul trouble, an experienced player, so they're taking a gamble that his experience will keep him away from a quick fourth.
Gale off the screen. Gale leaves it for Kane. Jams it home.
There's that perfect setup in terms of not being in a rush to get anything done. Ohio State continues to answer when they need to.
Smith to Edie. Good catch on his hip, and he's fouled on the floor. I think you had to foul him on that one, didn't you?
Yeah.
I do think that's where he's improved the most is his strength. He's always been an athletic kid at his size. He wants it inside. Clears the way for Jones.
They're getting good help from behind on him, though. Look over here, too. Yep.
Shot clock at five.
Another good possession defensively.
Braden Smith from 17. Nothing but net.
There's a guy who knows how to answer, though. Once again, just like I mentioned at the Ohio State end, utilizing the clock and not panicking, same thing can be said for Purdue at their end.
So many improvements for Purdue this year. Jones coming in from Southern Illinois, big improvement. But Braden Smith's game has been a revelation for the Boilermakers.
A changer for them, for sure.
Thornton trying to answer. Thornton doesn't get the bounce.
He had to adjust that shot, that's why.
Battle for three, first of the day.
That had smooth written all over it, didn't it?
Well, that's a guy that's taken a lot of those shots because he was in rhythm.
That was just really, really smooth.
He leads the Big Ten in three-point shooting percentage.
Look at this.
He just couldn't corral it, and it's knocked away.
You just can throw a fastball up there. Watch out, folks.
Matt Painter taking some contacts. Here come the Buckeyes. Battle again for three. Yes!
Streaky. Boy, he can't wait to get that ball off and catch it in the corner. You know, the tops of the NCAA for a reason in terms of number two.
6-0 run for Ohio State. Remember, Edie, last year in the Big Ten tournament, 32 points, 14 rebounds against Ohio State. Held a 10 so far in this game.
Had to have him way out on the floor, too.
Braden Smith to Lawyer. Lawyer inside. Zed Keys there.
He was open for a second, but 2 seconds he wasn't open.
Battle for three again.
Glad we're not guarding him right now. He has found the range.
That's 13 games this year with at least 3 3-pointers for Jamison Battle.
Yeah, in his last 2 games, he's only averaged 5.5 points. But before that, in the last previous three before that, he was averaging 19. So he can score it.
14 minutes to play. Smith has it knocked away. These turnovers, Matt Painter said, were the biggest problem last year. And in the losses this year, 17 and 14 turnovers. And I think your point about the Minnesota game when Purdue was down double digits, how they battled back in the second half is definitely something to look at. Battle again. This one no good. Braden Smith up the floor.
I think if that one went, some of the people on the Purdue bench might have left.
They might have had to tie the roof down a little bit, too. Morton out front.
Here's that. Watch it. Edie fill the middle of the floor now. Slowly. There he goes right now.
And Smith is fouled. Is that a pass or a shot?
Variations of getting Edie the basketball.
There's the extra help. Jones. He's been cool today. Not right now, though.
Somebody has to step up. And he's the guy who's played very well for them. Nice outlet pass there from the post, from the perimeter.
It's only the second three of the day for the Boilermakers. It's what opens up the middle for them and Zach Edey a lot of times. Ball knocked away by Smith.
You got to get on it.
Oh, how about that save by Gillis?
Still got to get on it.
Shot clock is at five. They go three-quarter court. Zed Key with the shot clock at one. No good. Well, the rebound by Gillis. Still got to get on it.
Yeah, well, you do, because all I saw was Smith, and I know exactly what he was going to do. He was going to the floor. Watch, they'll float Edie back to the middle of the floor like this and finish. Forget about it.
Four for their last four on field goals, and that's the easiest of the four.
Now, Ohio State has to make an adjustment on the fly right now to seal up the middle of the floor, because they're going to ride Edie as best they can.
Free throw line jumper is good. Nice friendly roll by Dale Bonner. He doesn't score a whole lot, but they're 10-1 when he plays 20 minutes or more.
Yeah, 3 scoreless games in his last 6, but he'll take every one of those little floaters. Here, a little look from this side of the floor now. Here we go, over the top though.
Gillis was there to clean it up. ED has it spotted away. Key's hands have been excellent today.
They got a 3-on-2 if they hurry.
High step into the basket, laying it in.
There he goes, Bonner.
And he said Gene Smith, the outgoing athletic director for Ohio State, told him the same thing. Look out for the kids.
Yeah, and you know, Tom, the other side of that, and I agree 100% with that, but it's also an audition for other schools.
No doubt. They go to Edie. Purdue does down low. 11.5 to play in the second half.
Yep, here they come. Somebody's got a Gillis. He's usually a guy who can shoot. Not on that one.
And the push from behind. Key says it's him.
But I don't want to get him touches there because now he's got to work a little bit.
That's going to be back-to-back fouls on Key. That'll be his third. Purdue is perfect for the free throw line. And they continue that. Now 8 for 8. And he makes both.
70% for the big guy, and you think that form. He's missed a bunch of a few games this year that probably would be up at 75%.
Well, he's so athletic. I mean, he was an ice hockey player, he was a baseball player. And of course, now the reigning player of the year in college basketball. Hafey hands it off to Middleton. Shot clock at 10. Middleton pull up jumper short. And first with the rebound. First and E both in at the same time.
Watch for a little high low action. And first may get the ball down low, too.
Brandon nice Smith. That was a great seal.
Sure was.
Count the bucket. Either way, but that's 7 straight double figure games for Braden Smith. Thornton back in so that knee's feeling better.
Yeah, and a pretty big possession right here for Ohio State.
And that shot blocked away by Edie.
Good look.
And then the steal by the Buckeyes. And a timeout call.
Yeah, before he got to the out of bounds.
Nope, they said he went out. They said he went out. That was close.
Yeah, it really was.
Here's Thornton. They leave it up top. Shot blocked away by Braden Smith. Now Morton helping to lead the break. Smith thought about a three. They thought better of it.
That was a beautiful block, wasn't it?
Sure was.
Boy,
he saw somebody his size. First down low. That means Edie is on Middleton. That's a size advantage. Edie wants the ball on the other side.
And they switch back.
Yep. Here's Jones right to the cup. He can't do it, but it's finished up by Edie.
One thing that Edie does very well, too, Tom, is he tracks the basketball. Keeps an eye on it and never quits on those short plays like that. A lot of guys would have figured that would have been an easy layup, run down the other side. He finishes it off, though.
Well, he's on the doorstep of his 58th career double-double. He has 9 rebounds.
They're on the doorstep of chipping into this league, more importantly for Purdue as a team.
Shot clock at 5. Bonner trying to get it inside. Turnover forced by Purdue. This is reminiscent of the Minnesota game in a lot of ways.
Yeah, they just keep coming at you. They keep coming at you.
Jones from the free throw line. He was coming down.
Yep. Defensively. Made him readjust that shot midair or would have been blocked. Big possession here for Ohio State.
Yeah, just to kind of settle things down a little bit.
Get the fans back into this. Sometimes Thornton will take it on by himself, but he's got Morton, a pretty good defender on him.
Shot clock under 10. Thornton goes outside for Bonner. Bonner up top for Middleton off the front of the rim. The two freshmen were hot in the first half. There was a speed bump in the middle of the floor there.
It was first and Middleton.
Both coaches had their arms out. They each wanted a foul. Smith leans. First with the rebound. First has it blocked away by Okpara. Picked up by Smith. Okpara has at least one block now in 30 consecutive games. Smith leans. Smith off the side of the rim. Edie with the rebound. Edie put back, no good. Smith tries it. Everybody's trying it.
You see why Smith is a pretty good rebounder, the second leading rebounder on this team, the way he puts himself in the action and the traffic.
Under 8 to play. I would think Battle, he's at the scorer's table. Yeah, he has 3 fouls. He's going to come in soon. Thornton, his jumper good.
I was going to say, you have to make that shot. He can make that shot constantly. Pretty good patience when they needed a bucket just then.
Edie, you see that note, 19 double-doubles this year, third most in college basketball, 58 for his career. And he's fouled going up.
Notice how high that pass was caught.
And stayed.
They stayed right there, rolling to the basket. It was not coming down.
And to a sea of students, he converts the first. He came into today's game needing 21 points to move into third place all-time in scoring in Purdue history, and he has 18.
Nice touch at the line, even though he's had some struggles here and there.
Yeah, they're now 11 for 11 from the free throw line, as you see the foul trouble for Ohio State. Key is on the floor, Battle is on the floor.
This matchup is pretty good for Morton and Purdue.
Shot clock under 10, Gal off the screen. Gal sneaking, Gal up top. Mahaffey for three, no good. And Edie with an easy rebound.
That's because I believe Edie was playing Mahaffey that trip down the floor for a moment.
Which Matt Painter did tell us that they may do that. Put him on the fours.
There we go. Bang.
Blocked away, Mahaffey. Good timing. Battle.
Nice.
Got some separation for three. Yeah, we had a good look at that one.
Yeah, you could see that drifting to the right.
Six and a half to play in the second half. Purdue's won nine straight. First inside for Edie.
Yep.
And keeping it high, which he didn't do in the first half. First wants it, and now they'll reset.
And just go forward to Smith when they kick it out to him. He'll shoot it.
Shot clock is down to three. Smith from the baseline. Cut off.
Keep pushing right now. You have numbers.
Gale. No look pass. Battle lays it in.
Good decision. Don't look behind you. There's nobody going to catch you if you get out to half court that fast.
Battle's second half points now 13.
Yeah, and the way Purdue is clamped down defensively, it sure is nice for Ohio State to get a transition layup, right? An easy one. Nothing's easy, but that was easier.
Fletcher.
Yeah, he floats down the middle of the lane now to set himself up.
Shot clock is at seven, and Lawyer will go to the line for two.
So many times we see guys flare to the corners on a three-on-one and shoot a three. Take the layup.
Akpara's in with four because Key is out with four for Ohio State. So they're going to have to manage these last 5.5 minutes with the two bigs. And Lawyer to the line again. They're 13 for 13 from the free throw line today.
And Lawyer's 82%, so that's a guy you want at the line for Purdue.
And the lead is back to five for Ohio State. Thornton into the paint. Step back over Edie and got the roll.
Well done. Again, he's reading Edie perfectly in terms of when do I challenge or when do I not. A little foul in the backcourt right there by Gale.
In, and Jones continues what has been a stellar day for Purdue from the free throw line. But the old adage is, if a shooter gets to the line, sometimes that frees him up.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going away in the last 5 minutes, that's for sure.
Ohio State had a double-digit lead in this half. Purdue's largest lead was eight in the first half. Thornton. Over the top again of Edie. It's the third time today.
I'm giggling to myself because he has that shot down to a T in terms of how he effectively looks at Edie right in the face. Edie was a little closer that trip, too, but he still challenged them off the bounce.
That's seven 20-point games this year for the sophomore Bruce Thornton. Edie to the basket. Didn't have the angle, but the cleanup was there. Count the bucket. Kaufman Wren. Is on Battle, so they have three guys with 4 fouls now.
52% free throw shooter. He steps up and hits one.
So they're gonna have to bring the veteran Battle out and bring the freshman Middleton in because of the foul trouble, at least for the time being.
It's good Ohio State is playing on their home floor, as I mentioned, with freshmen and sophomores playing 70% of their minutes, rather than being on the road. Look at the hesitation. He's got to find somebody sooner or later.
Board up against
Here you go.
The three-pointer by Battle is good.
Another good decision by Thornton not to challenge Edie. See Edie, though, at 7-4, got his defensive stance like he was a guard.
Three-point shooting has been a huge factor today. Purdue has been limited. Lawyer inside Edie, and it's cut off, and a foul is called. That's going to go against Okara, so he's going to be out.
Yeah, I thought he moved his feet pretty well just then to kind of get a hand on that.
The other part of it, too, they haven't turned the ball over today. They only have 6 turnovers. 18-for-18, back to a 5-point game.
Let's see if they extend a little bit here. Yeah, it looks like, look at Edie. Edie's on the ball.
Defending the inbound. And Jones will be called for the pushing foul.
That's only team number 4, though.
They go to Bonner. Working against Smith.
Lead that ball out in front of Smith. He'll go for a steal once in a while.
Yeah, look at his eyes. He's
waiting for it to leave his hands for that bounce.
Thornton against Jones. Blocked away by Edie.
Not a good decision, right? We've seen good decisions. Good move there, too, by Jones to put the brakes on a little bit with Thornton right behind him.
Jones connects.
76 for Ohio State, so you would have thought that would have been maybe a little edge coming in.
Thornton now will speed away from Jones, who went after the steal.
Now it's the balance of playing smart and playing with some tempo and not squeezing the air out of the clock.
Now they're going to look at the shot clock, because it's at 9 right now. And
come to the ball.
Thornton covered up by Jones.
They don't foul a lot.
Nope. That's a tough spot for Thornton to give up the basketball. He'll get it back, and he lost it. He'll go inside for Mahaffey. Shot clock is under 5. Mahaffey over the top of Edie. No good. That's 7-4 and more.
Yeah, that lost ball cost him about 3 quality seconds when Thornton sent it straight up.
Purdue could tie this game up. It's a 1-possession ball game.
That's a drop pass back to the middle.
And a timeout call by Matt Painter.
This is a seasoned team we're looking at right here in Purdue. Don't expect them to get rattled.
Smith with the shot clock at 5. Ball is knocked out of bounds. Shot clock is just at 3 as Gale knocked it out of bounds. It is Smith open for 3. No good. Nice ball tip. Tipped
down. Real good tip. And a good pullback here.
Gale open for 3 for Ohio State. It's no good. And Lawyer with an easy board for the Boilermakers.
And that's the way they talked about playing fast before Purdue could get set up defensively. Not so sure they wanted that quickly.
Boilermakers are 1 for their last 11, but they've used the free throw line to come within 3. Jones, 4-3. It's good.
He got buried right around that screen. He got his shoulders low enough to get around the screen. The defender couldn't find him and catch up to him.
That's 12 games now this year where Jones has at least 3 threes. He's woken up. It's a 7-0 run. Battle from the free throw line. Scissor lifts.
Well, one of the things about Battle is he knows it's 6-7 with that jumper. Jumper against Lawyer. He has some size advantage. And you just love to watch Lefty shoot.
After a tumultuous week here in Columbus, it's down to just basketball for the final minute against Purdue.
They're trying to get it to the big guy. Here he is.
Remember, Key has 4 fouls.
Nice hands up. We've seen it 5 times or so this afternoon.
And Thornton is fouled up top by Lawyer.
Yeah. Hand on leather. It's a distinct sound. So they've been doing that and playing it well. It's not a foul to my eye.
Ohio State run a little clock here before they find a shot.
Yeah, not too much though. Want to get it into rhythm. You don't want to get down to 5 seconds.
Here's Battle. He's had a big second half. Battle's fouled. And he'll get a couple of free throws.
Morton just a touch out of position there defensively.
First free throw attempt in the second half for Ohio State. And Battle's made 35 straight free throws.
Each team has a timeout, too.
Yep.
Smooth, isn't it?
36 straight.
Wow.
It's a four-point game. A two-possession game. And Roddy Gale was knocked to the ground.
He was hammered on a screen in the backcourt. But they'll try to get a drive to the basket if they can with Smith.
Lawyer looks in up top for Gillis.
Good help there defensively.
And Gillis cutting to the basket. Got some separation. Whoa. He missed the bunny. But Edie's there to clean it on up. So 69-67. Full court pressure with Edie on the ball. And a timeout call by Jake Diemann. That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no Edie. He's on the bench.
Oh, they faked them out good.
Here's Battle. 12 seconds left. Mahaffey.
Foul him. He's at like 61%.
He's right.
Yeah, you had your choices there with the catches. 83% goes to the line rather than a 61%er in Bonner.
8 seconds to play. Converts.
And remember, if he misses this shot, the three goes for naught, though, if he makes a free throw here.
Two-possession game, 71-67.
Now you stay away. Oh, watch out. Another big screen.
Smith going right to the dish. And he gets it to go. 2 seconds left. No timeouts for either team. Mahaffey will inbound to Battle.
That's the guy you want. Put that free throw shooter to the line all day.
If you're Ohio State, that's the guy you want.
Yes, that's what I mean. Yeah.
Front end. Well, he's good.
Roll those shoulders towards the basket. That helps.
Second free throw. It's good.
That's what you do if you're a 95% free throw shooter.
And they just let it go. Right?
Oh, yeah. You stay away.
They throw it up for Edie. It's tipped away. The Ohio State Buckeyes. They were shocked earlier this week with a coaching change. And they rocked the college basketball world today with a four-point win. Kind of a huge exhale for the Buckeyes. Jake Diebler, the interim head coach,